Okay, guys, I never thought I'd have to do this story, but after Snowmageddon yesterday, I'm about to tell you something that could save your life, or at least help you from hurting yourself with all the ice outside. Did you know there's actually an art to falling on ice? Remember this guy and his driveway fall? Yeah, that was pretty slippery and scary. Well, there's no magical trick, but NBC News did speak with a professional stuntman about a less painful way to break the ice. Get it? You see what I did there? First, bend your knees. If you know you're gonna fall, the best thing you can do is get closer to the ground. This instantly reduces the distance of your fall, and you can tell that man didn't do that. Second, keep your arms away from each other. Keep your arms away from you when you're about to fall. Using your arms to help break your fall could actually make you, look at him. Oh gosh, I hate that video. It actually could end up breaking your arm. So this is just a few tips to make sure that you don't injure yourself now that we're slipping and sliding on ice that is still on the ground.
Can't break any hips now. That can't happen.
Yeah, so keep keep your arms close to you.
Okay,
don't heal like we used to.
So let's say we're that guy right there. We start going.
Wiggling.
Am I going forward? Am I going to try and fall backward? Where am I going
to
go?
I got a plot twist for you. You're actually supposed to fall on your side because, so your arm and your thigh, your leg, that's what breaks the fall. But the biggest thing is you don't want to, boop, hit your head. So these two.
And then speaking of the head, they say it's important just to tuck your chin.
Right.
Kind of like when you're tumbling. Remember gymnastics days? Did you ever do gymnastics?
Right. You don't want to get
your
a concussion.
Head. Tuck your chin to your chest to prevent your head from hitting the ground.
Exactly.
Like that.
Okay. All right. Either way.
Right in the nook.
Either way, your side, tuck your head, you're going to hit the ground, and you may hurt something. How you treat yourself? Is there a way to...
So a couple of the biggest things that you can injure, actually, I know it's like, it's funny, right? But you could actually like really injure yourself. You could break your wrist, you could fracture your wrist, you could get a herniated disc as well. Those are two of the top things that are injuries from falling on ice. So ironically, you use ice to heal yourself until you can get to a trained medical professional.
So you just lay there for a few
Well, sometimes it is important just to stay put and feel like what's moving, what's not.
Right. What's
get a
sticking
little,
out.
Get a little of an assessment. What's sticking out? Hopefully not.
Yeah. Right.
And then move on.
That ice helps with the inflammation and also Tylenol and ibuprofen. Those could also be helpful.
All right. Now you have to remember everything as you're making that quick fall.
Yeah, tuck, side,
tuck,
inflammatory.
Drop, sideways.
Drop, and roll.